Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. A Christian, a Muslim, and a graduate from BYU walk into a bar. And that's just the first guy. And it's not so much a bar as it is today's episode of Outlet Portland. Sorry. Outlet Portland starts right now on Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Then the Lord answered Job out of the whirlwind and said, "Who is this that darkeneth counsel by words without knowledge? Where was thou when I laid the foundations of the earth? Declare, if thou hast understanding. Knowest thou the ordinances of heaven? Canst thou set the dominion thereof in the earth?" That is Job 38:4 through 33, as God Almighty excoriates a man who would question the will and the plan of the divine. But of course, such wonderings can never be avoided. Believers and non-believers alike spend billions of hours every year debating the meaning of certain scriptural passages, of certain faiths. At times, it seems that religions, like the political parties that they sometimes mirror, can never be made whole, that they are jigsaw pieces. They are puzzle pieces that can never be brought together because no one can actually agree on the shape. Dr. Nader Pourhassan, PhD, was born and raised in Tehran, Iran, and raised to be, in his words, a fanatical supporter of Islam. He moved to the United States when he was 14 and has spent the last 20 years researching the Quran and the Bible in depth. Like 99.9% of all deep thinkers worth knowing, he currently resides right here in Portland, Oregon. His most recent book is God's Scripture, A Faithful Comparison. Welcome to Outlook Portland, sir.
Thank you for having me.
You were born in Iran. What was the political climate like during your formative years in Iran?
Ever since I've known in Iran, since I was born, I've seen religion around me. So everybody were going by some kind of rules that was given to them by the religious leaders. Even in Shah's time, everybody were conducting themselves according to the religious leader's rule book. So I think the religion always ruled in Iran. And as I read the history book, it's 1,000 years or so that religion was always part of people's life.
Westerners are taught that Iran is a very repressive and brutal theocracy, and that is the image that is given to us by much of the media. To what extent is that exaggerated or true in your
experience? It's true that it's a theocracy, but brutal. I think it started when Ayatollah Khomeini started the revolution. He didn't get along with his own teacher. He was Ayatollah Burujerdi, and he was a very moderate religious leader. He get along with Shah, and they had the religious rules, and Shah had governed the country. But Khomeini changed that. Khomeini made it very brutal, says anybody who doesn't obey the laws of religious leaders, they should be put to death. And when that started, then the whole revolution happened, and all the things that we see today, that people are very tired of it, is what's happening.
And growing up, and I'm a child of the 80s in many ways, and I remember growing up and seeing Khomeini on television, and the way that he was depicted, at least by the American media, it was, as you said, it was a very strict interpretation, and it was a very overbearing, very strong interpretation of religious law. When you grow up in that environment, to what extent is your religion even a choice?
Well, not only just that religion, it's not your choice, you grow in it. But even in Christianity, I don't see many people saying, okay, I went and read the Bible and then I choose to be a Christian. Usually they are born into a Christian family and then they accept that faith. But in Iran, the way Khomeini brought all of these things to us is, he wanted us to follow his rules, and if we don't, we will be banned by him. But as a person who grew up with him, I loved him. I thought he was a good man. And whenever he would talk about, let's give more freedom to the poor people. Let's take care of the poor people. Let's stand up against this big guy, America. Let's do, something that we become somebody also. So his talkings were, very attractive to the people who were listening. Yeah, we don't need to be bullied around by anybody. The question of how did they bully us was not even addressed. It was automatically accepted by people.
It was a given.
It was a given, yeah.
You described yourself as, at that time in your life, as being a fanatical Muslim. And because the words Muslim and fanatic are often used in tandem by large sections of the editorial press, It's worth asking, what does that mean to you? How would you define that?
Okay, I'm going to tell you what it means to me, and then I'm going to tell you what Quran actually says what is fanatic, which is very interesting. To me, fanatic, when I was fanatic, I thought a person who calls himself Hezbollah, that means a member of God's party, mm-hmm. the man who would be giving everything to God. He would not stop from giving his life or money to God. But the fanatic in Quran is described as don't be so much to the right and don't be so much to the left. Do not live an extreme life. Be in the middle. There is only one place you can be extreme according to the Quran, and that is when you want to be kind. There is no limit. Be as kind as you want to be. Be as loving as you can be, where God is infinite love, so just be as infinitely as you can be loving. But nowhere it says be harsh as you can be. And that's what fanatic comes, you know, to be.
I really have to say that as uneducated as I feel most of the time, I feel infinitely more so right now. It's one of those days where I realize I really need to go back to school, like, forever. We're talking with Dr. Nader Pourhassan. You are watching Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there. We return after this. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. True believers, non-believers, anyone in between, there's something on which we can all agree, and that is what is best in life. The thrill of crushing an opponent underfoot. And what better place to do that than at Geek Trivia Night, brought to you by the marquee sponsor of Outlook Portland, Things from Another World. You can demonstrate your knowledge at Geek Trivia Night and win a passel of all things nerd-like. Things from Another World gift certificates, comics, action figures, perhaps a place in Valhalla. Or, you know, whatever. It happens alternating Tuesdays at the Vendetta Bar, which is at 4306 North Williams Avenue. The next night the Geek Trivia takes place is Tuesday, June 15th. No cover, but you got to be 21 to attend. So we will see you there. Be sure to tell me you heard about it right here on Outlook Portland.